In Afghanistan, at least 10 people have been killed and 10 more were wounded in a multiple attack on the British consul in Kabul. A suicide bomber struck and a dozen men armed with heavy machine guns and rocket-propelled grenades stormed the building. Here's Nick Childs.
Afghan and international security forces quickly swooped on the site of the attack. It had been an elaborate and determined assault on the British Council offices, including a vehicle bomb to try to breach the wall of the compound.
The first suicide attack happened in a vehicle, and the second one was on foot. We were the first group who got here, and right now we have sealed the area and the attackers are not moving.
From London, the Foreign Office said all British nationals are now safe, thanks to good security measures and the presence of mind of the British Council staff. It condemned the attack as despicable. Well after the initial attack, gunfire could still be heard amid reports that at least one attacker was still holding out against the security forces. Another casualty is led away. As the Afghan security forces collect the debris from the assault, graphic evidence that these were heavily armed attackers. The Afghan capital was already on high alert. It's a national holiday to mark the 92nd anniversary of Afghan independence from British rule. That was the reason for the timing of this attack, according to the Taliban, who say they carried it out. It's certainly another high-profile assault to challenge and embarrass both the Afghan government and its NATO and international allies. Nick Childs, BBC News.